ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਦਿਸ ਐਪੀਸੋਡ ਆਫ ਦ ਹਰਪ੍ਰੀਤ ਸਿੰਘ ਸ਼ੋਅ। ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਸੈਗਮੈਂਟ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ ਡਗ ਕਲਮ ਨਾਲ, ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕਿ ਸੇਫ ਸਰੀ ਕੋਲੇਸ਼ਨ ਤੋਂ ਮੇਅਰਲ ਕੈਂਡੀਡੇਟ ਨੇ। ਆਓ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਕੋਲੋਂ ਜਾਣਕਾਰੀ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਉਹ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਨੇ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਸਮਝਦੇ ਨੇ ਸਰੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਤਬਦੀਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਲੋੜ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਕੀ ਕੁਝ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਏਜੰਡਾ ਹੈ, ਕੀ ਕੁਝ ਇਹ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਲਈ ਕਰਨਗੇ। ਸਵਾਗਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਡਗ ਕਲਮ ਦਾ। ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ।
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਫਾਰ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਮੀ।
ਯੂ ਆਰ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਅ ਰਿਟਾਇਰਡ ਲਾਈਫ, ਗੋਇੰਗ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ ਮੀਟਿੰਗ ਯਰ ਚਿਲਡਰਨ ਸਮ ਟਾਈਮ ਇਨ ਨਿਊਜ਼ੀਲੈਂਡ ਐਂਡ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ ਦ ਵਰਲਡ। ਵਾਟ ਪ੍ਰੋਮਪਟਡ ਯੂ ਟੂ ਥਿੰਕ ਆਫ ਜੰਪਿੰਗ ਬੈਕ ਇਨ ਟੂ ਦਿਸ ਰੇਸ?
ਵੈਲ, ਯੂ ਨੋ, ਵੀ ਡਿਡ, ਵੀ ਡੋਨਾ, ਮਾਈ ਵਾਈਫ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਟ੍ਰੈਵਲ, ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਕਿਡਸ ਇਨ ਕੁਆਟਾਰ ਐਂਡ ਨਿਊਜ਼ੀਲੈਂਡ ਐਂਡ ਹਾਂਗਕਾਂਗ ਐਂਡ ਵੀ ਵਰ ਵਿਜ਼ਿਟਿੰਗ ਦੈਮ ਆਲ ਐਂਡ But when I was back in Surrey and I went around and traveled throughout Surrey, many, many people, hundreds of people, if not thousands, over a two-year period, came to me and said, you know, Doug, our city is going downhill. It's sliding every year over the last number of years. We want you to get in. With your experience, just get in and turn it around. Bring in a new team. You're a problem solver, you're a doer. We need it. We need to get our city turned around and headed in the right direction.
Mm-hmm. So that's what prompted you and motivated you to be back.
Very much so. Mm-hmm. I said, okay, I have a passion for Surrey. I want to help the people in Surrey. And when I see that they're hurting, they're fragile, they feel very, very unsafe mm-hmm. in our communities because of the gang violence and the shootings. And, you know, especially the drive-by shootings, you know, people say, just visualize a house in Newton. About a month ago, a car drove up, shot 5 shots into the house, yeah. and then drove off. And the whole neighborhood heard it. The neighborhood had their kids at home. I mean, that really shocks the neighborhood. And, mm-hmm. you know, they're saying, we have to get this stopped. So.
Right.
It was one reason why I said, you know, let's get in and make some really serious changes.
So, Doug, crime has been a major issue for which we have been lately in the news. But along with that, these days also we have been in the news for some other reasons, the voter fraud and voter intimidation and all these things happening. Yeah. What do you feel? What's happening over here? What's happening in Surrey?
Well, it's just multiplying in mm-hmm. a whole number of areas. We have this voter alleged fraud that's happening out in our community, and, mm-hmm. and there's no place for that. You know, I don't have any patience for that type of thing. We actually have called on both the Wake Up Surrey and the RCMP to provide the names to the public, because mm-hmm. the public deserves to know who's behind this,
right.
you know. And I feel very strongly, that's our democratic process. Mm-hmm. That's what countries are based on, is their voting. And to have this type of alleged fraud happening just really makes me sick. It just destroys me. But we need to get to the bottom. We need to have those names out in the public so that people recognize who they are. We can't wait till after election, because it's part of the election. And
right.
so we need to do it. And on the safety end of it in our communities, in the gang violence and mm-hmm. all that, the very first meeting that we have, we're going to withdraw from the RCMP mm-hmm. and we're going to form our own city police force.
Right.
The RCMP with their officers, they only stay in Surrey for 3 or 4 years. They're trained in rural policing, mm-hmm. not urban policing, which
right.
Surrey's a large city now. It's 10th largest in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
We need officers that are trained in urban. And above everything, the RCMP is managed and directed from Ottawa.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, what does Ottawa know about the problems in Surrey?
Right.
So we're going to form our own city police. They'll have a police board made up entirely of people from Surrey
mm-hmm.
that will manage and direct it. The officers will come and live in our community.
Mm-hmm.
They'll be in Surrey for their careers. That type of bond with our communities will start to make our communities feel a lot safer.
Right.
The police will be walking with them with their kids to school, because they'll
right.
live in Surrey, to our playing fields. And so it's something that needs to be done right away. If I could do it before the election, I would do I would do it tomorrow, because I feel it's that important that we get going
on. Right, so that's one aspect about which you're very particular, that the day you get elected, you will have the local police, Surrey police will be in effect.
Yes.
But the issue is that what other means do you think needs to be adopted to tackle this issue of violence and gangs in Surrey?
Well, I think there's a whole number of areas that also need to be addressed. I had a personal experience where my son used to teach at Tumanera School, grade 11. And I had somebody up that was filming me, a young person from Simon Fraser. He was doing some filming of me for his class in Simon Fraser. And he came over to me and he said, "Mr. McCallum, I just wanted to tell you that your son saved my life." Mm-hmm. I said, "What?" He said, "I was in Tumanus, grade 11, and he said, there's a gap in high school with kids from about 2:30 when they get out of school till 6 when their parents get home.
Right.
That gap, the kids leave school and they go to a nearby park and they hang out, and the gangs are right there and they're always after them." And he said, "I just about joined one of these gangs." He said, "But your son started a rugby team after school." And so he said, "We, whole bunch of them and his friends joined this rugby team." And all the high schools around Surrey have a rugby, and they have a league and the teams play. So he said, "We need to keep the kids busy after school." And, and you know, I think that's sort of a simple sort of personal experience, but that's what we need to do.
So you'll get the city involved in, you know, involving the public's children to be involved with sports by providing them more fields and providing them better facilities?
Yeah, we've already announced we're going to build a lot more playing fields, a lot more recreation, a lot more cultural too. And so that the kids after school especially can get involved. And if you combine that with our communities feeling safer, then the parents will take more interest and they'll become coaches for the teams. They'll come out and cheer their kids when they're playing after school. And so getting our own city police force, plus doing a number of other things, I think you start to see that the community then starts to get involved a lot more and it becomes safer.
Thanks for your perspective. We'll go for a short break. We'll be back and learn more as to what else will you be providing to the citizens of Surrey after this break. Ajkal di market vich apne ghar nu cheti vechan di soch rahe ho, ta fir staging zarur kara lo. Khali ghar uninviting te cold lagda hai, jadke stage kita hoya ghar warmth, color te khali jagah nu vadhiya bana dinda hai. ਆਪਣੇ ਘਰ ਨੂੰ ਸੇਲ ਤੇ ਲਾਉਣ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰ ਐਨ ਐਲੀਗੈਂਟ ਟੱਚ ਹੋਮ ਸਟੇਜਿੰਗ ਤੇ ਡਿਜ਼ਾਈਨ ਦੀ ਰੀਟਾ ਚੌਹਾਨ ਨਾਲ ਗੱਲ ਜ਼ਰੂਰ ਕਰ ਲਓ, ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਆਪਣੇ ਸਕਿੱਲਸ ਤੇ ਐਕਸਪੀਰੀਅੰਸ ਨਾਲ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਘਰ ਨੂੰ ਟੌਪ ਡਾਲਰਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੇਚਣ ਵਿੱਚ ਤੁਹਾਡੀ ਮਦਦ ਕਰ ਸਕਣ। ਕਾਲ 6046576612 ਜਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਵੈਬਸਾਈਟ anelegantouch.ca ਤੇ ਜਾਓ। ਵਾਂਸ ਅਗੇਨ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਬੈਕ ਟੂ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ। ਬ੍ਰੇਕ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਡਗ ਮਕਲਮ ਨੇ ਦੱਸਿਆ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਸਰੀ RCMP ਜੋ ਹੈ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਭੰਗ ਕਰਕੇ ਲੋਕਲ ਪੁਲਿਸ ਜੋ ਹੈ ਉਸਦੇ ਹਮਾਇਤੀ ਨੇ, ਅਤੇ ਨਾਲ ਹੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਸੇਫਟੀ ਦਾ ਮੈਜਰਸ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਹੋਰ ਬੈਟਰ ਹੋਣੇ ਚਾਹੀਦੇ ਨੇ, ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਹੋਰ ਪਲੇ ਫੀਲਡਸ, ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਬਿਹਤਰ ਤਾਲਮੇਲ ਜੋ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਸਿਟੀ ਜੋ ਹੈ ਉਸ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਯਤਨ ਕਰੇਗੀ। ਇਹ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਮੁੱਖ ਫੋਕਸ ਰਹੇਗਾ। ਹੋਰ ਕਿਹੜੇ ਮੁੱਦੇ ਨੇ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਇਹ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਨਗੇ ਉਹ ਹੋਰ ਜਾਣਕਾਰੀ ਲੈਣੇ। ਸੋ ਯੂ ਟਾਕਡ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਅ ਬੈਟਰ ਲਾਇਜੋਨ ਬਿਟਵੀਨ ਦ ਪਬਲਿਕ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਸਿਟੀ ਹਾਲ। I would like to touch a little bit about the City Hall. You have been in the City Hall for a long period. Now, what ails the City Hall? What do you feel which needs to be changed, and that will be a top priority to the functioning of the City Hall to be better for the common people?
Well, I think it first of all starts with what I've seen around the community. First of all, the City Hall is the people's hall. It's not council's, not the mayor's hall. It's the people's hall. It's like the people's home. And why should they have to pay, first of all, to go to City Hall? Like, would you pay to go back to your house and so forth? And so, you know, like, it never made sense why, if you have to go to get permits, or you have to go to pay your taxes, or to get information, why do you have to pay? So we're going to do away with the parking as soon as we get in. Pay parking in the City Hall. We're not going to have any. It's going to be free for our people to use. And within the City Hall, the different departments have to be overhauled completely and streamlined and become a lot more efficient. I've heard scary stories that permits take 6-8 months. Right. I've heard stories where the people go up to the counter and just get refused. And when people go in, they're worried. And that, you know, they need some information. Mm-hmm. Like, we have to be customer-based. That's what the City Hall, and it's not right now. And so we have to get our staff trained better. We have to make sure we're a lot more efficient. We should be able to get building permits literally in 2 or 3 weeks, not 6 months. Mm-hmm. And so we're going to overhaul both the planning department and the engineering department completely. Mm-hmm. So that we get a lot better and a lot more efficient service for the residents of Surrey.
Right. So while you talked about paid parking will be stopped from the City Hall, but what about the hospitals over here? Because already the people are burdened with the tensions what they have of their relatives or dear and near ones, and then they have to pay, and in case even they are a little late, they have to further pay for the tickets and all that.
Yeah, we've already announced that we are going to do away, again in our first day, because it's very simple to do, we're going to take all the parking meters off our streets around the hospital, and it'll be free parking for people going to the hospital. Okay. I had to go to that hospital recently to see a friend, and when you go to the hospital, you know, you're under tension. I mean, and why should you have to worry about parking when you're going in to visit a sick one or a loved one or a family member? You have to worry about it, and you get in there, and then you have to worry about whether the parking meter's going to expire, and you know, the people they have doing tickets was another thing. They sit there, and they wait till the parking meter goes, and whip, you gotta sit. Right. We're going to do away with them, too, because, you know, we want our people to enjoy being and not have to worry about parking. So again, we're going to take all the parking meters out around the hospital.
No LRT, but SkyTrain, you are propagating that. Why do you feel that LRT is not a good option for Surrey?
Well, you know, people in Surrey have told me very much, and I was on the TransLink board for 9 years. I was chairman of it when we built the Canada Line, the Evergreen Line, and people told me Surrey's waited for 30 years to have rapid transit line, and they want the same thing as Vancouver, Burnaby, New Westminster, Tri-Cities, Richmond, the airport, same thing, SkyTrain type technology. When it became Surrey's turn, this current Surrey First Council said, nope, stop, we're not gonna do SkyTrain. Mm-hmm. Just said, we waited 30 years to get this. And they said, no, we're gonna put light rail in. Right. Light rail doesn't work in Surrey, we're too big, it will cause further gridlock on our roads, it's dangerous. SkyTrain is already proven technology. It's safe, efficient, it moves. The Expo line, which we're going to extend along Fraser Highway out to Langley, and the second phase going from our city center down through Newton to South Surrey, those lines carry 100,000 people a day. That's a lot of people. And if we can take that kind of people out of the cars in our streets, then it will start to alleviate the gridlock that currently everybody in Surrey has.
So are you sure, Mr. Doug, that the money part will be looked into? It'll be the same as is being said, that it'll cost much, much more for SkyTrain as compared to the LRT. Are you sure that it'll be within these means that you'll be able to fulfill this promise?
Yeah, we've been promised by the federal government that the money of $1.65 billion will stay here if a new council comes in, and they will have discussions right away with us for SkyTrain.
Right.
The cost factor, I'm very familiar with cost. I was on TransLink when we built SkyTrain systems, two of them. The Evergreen Line, just for example, same length, distance, all above ground, SkyTrain technology. It actually had to go through a tunnel, finished last year, $1.4 billion. So we can certainly build the SkyTrain along the Fraser Highway for $1.65 billion.
Wonderful. These are the major issues which people are talking about now, to the point as to why should the people vote for Doug McCallum as mayor on October 20th?
Well, because I've listened to the people, and the Safe Surrey Coalition's got the best candidates that I have ever seen in Surrey. They're just from all parts of Surrey, all professions, and I'm very, very proud of them, and it's a great team. And I want to get in there with my experience and make changes to make Surrey better. And I've listened to the people, And my promise to the people of Surrey, if we get elected, we will do those things, but I promise that I will listen to the people before we do any of the things that we do in the future. It's important to recognize that we listen. We're going to reverse the public consulting process on development and put it in front of it rather than behind it. It's an important thing that we need to do to recognize that it's the people in Surrey that it's their city. We want to make them proud, and we want to listen to them.
Great. It was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you, and best wishes for October 28th, and we hope people in large numbers turn out and vote on that particular day. Thank you, and best wishes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. So, Johan Asit Galbat Kiti, us de vich Doug McCallum ne dusre hisse vich ehi keha hai ke sky train jadi hegi hai, eh itthe Surrey vich banange. ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਇਲਾਵਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਕਿ ਸਰੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਿਟੀ ਹਾਲ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦਾ ਸਿਟੀ ਹਾਲ ਹੈ, ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਓਵਰਹਾਲ ਕਰਨਗੇ ਅਤੇ ਆਮ ਜਨਤਾ ਜੋ ਹੈ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਸੁਣ ਕੇ ਹੀ ਇਹ ਫੈਸਲੇ ਕਰਨਗੇ। ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਪਬਲਿਕ ਨੂੰ ਪ੍ਰਾਇਰ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਸ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਜਾਵੇਗੀ, ਪੇਡ ਪਾਰਕਿੰਗ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਸਿਟੀ ਹਾਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਤੇ ਹੋਸਪਿਟਲਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹ ਖਤਮ ਕੀਤੀ ਜਾਵੇਗੀ, ਅਤੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਮੈਂ ਆਸ਼ਵਾਸਨ ਦੇਣਾ ਕਿ 20 ਤਰੀਕ ਨੂੰ ਜੇ ਮੈਂ ਜਿੱਤਾਂ ਨਾ ਤਾਂ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਹੀ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਮੈਂ ਸੁਣ ਕੇ ਅੱਗੇ ਫਰਦਰ ਕੰਸਲਟੇਸ਼ਨ ਕਰਕੇ ਡਿਸੀਜਨਸ ਲਿਆ ਕਰਾਂ।